And hello again, everyone. Mike Flanagan, Matt Turek here with you from InsideBowling.com as we continue to bring you coverage from the 2016 Southland Bowling League Championship. We've had action this morning. We had four matches. There's eight teams here. Four have moved to the loser's bracket. Four remain in the winner's bracket. And we have winner's bracket competition for you front and center right now. Lanes 13 and 14. We'll also have lanes 9 and 10 here in just a little bit. We've got Stephen F. Austin taking on Arkansas State. Arkansas State is the number two ranked team in the country right now. And Stephen F. Austin is looking for the upset here as they defeated Monmouth earlier. And Arkansas State had quite a battle with Louisiana Tech. Matt Turek, here we are again.
Yep, doing it one more time. Round two. Here we're watching Arkansas State. Haley Richard there with a nice strike to start the game off.
So this is our first look at Arkansas State. Nicole Michaelalian, if I'm saying that right, Nicole Michaelalian, that's a pretty cool name.
Yeah, it is.
She is the second bowler there for Arkansas State.
The 10-pin.
And now that is not what you want to do there starting out here in the second frame. Best of seven matches. Currently you see the zero and the zero indicating that we're just getting started.
Big shot for Stephen F. Austin.
They just came off a big win. It took seven games.
Yeah, it was very exciting. That was Kara Grant getting her team the double. Here's J.D. Scott-Jones. J.D. Scott-Jones averaged 192 this year. Through 40 games, bowled seven events.
The Southland Bowling League, second year in existence. Last year it was Vanderbilt defeating Arkansas State. We're here in Kenner, Louisiana at AMF All-Star Lanes. Coverage today all afternoon. We'll have 14 total matches. We brought you four this morning, four now. We'll have two more rounds of two matches coming up this afternoon. And then tomorrow morning, we'll have a semifinal and then a final. We'll crown a champion tomorrow afternoon. We're glad you're with us. You can interact with us in the chat on Inside Bowling on our YouTube page.
Brooke Wood with a nice strike. Tough break, though, for Stephen F. Austin, 4-9. Paige Crocher. Nine-pin for Brooke Wood of Arkansas State as Paige gets the count off the 4-9. Getting as many pins as they can. Tulane crowd is very vocal here.
Yeah, they are.
They're bowling on 5 and 6. They've got 5 in a row to start this game against Valpo.
And for the first time in this round, we'll go ahead, we'll take you down there
Tulane with six in a row on lane five.
If they continue to keep that going, we will get you some bonus coverage down there. Tulane and Valpo down on lanes 5 and 6 in the loser's bracket. Louisiana Tech and Monmouth
are down on lanes. They got 7 in a row. This place is loud.
Lane 17 and 18 is the other matchup. And then right here in front of us is we've been watching Arkansas State and Stephen F. Austin. And right now, Vanderbilt versus Sam Houston State. I will tell you right now, Matt, and as you know, I am a fashion expert.
You are.
My favorite team jerseys are Sam Houston State's.
You like them, huh?
Well, Inside Bowling's got orange in the logo, so I'm going with it.
That's why, huh?
Yep.
That's a good reason here.
But all of the ladies and all of the different teams have some really cool uniforms. I do want to say that.
I like Valpo's. And a bucket stops the run for Tulane. Down on lane five.
I will tell you this, if Valparaiso ends up getting defeated in this round, best four out of seven, they will have bowled really well and gotten knocked out of the tournament.
Yeah.
They are running into a red-hot Tulane team right now. But early on, very early on, a lot can happen.
Especially with when they switch lanes, possibly lane five is more open than lane six, and Valpo could bounce right back. Sam Houston, as you see on your screen, with a double.
Take you back down 13 and 14, Matt. They're a little bit ahead of the Vanderbilt-Sam Houston State match. So
here's Stephanie Mims for Arkansas State. She's going to be up on the left lane. She'll be starting the 10th frame. They are working on a double. Dakota Hazelwood running her 10-pin down. Stephanie with a 4-9, trips the 9 late. Got a lucky break there for Stephanie. Stephanie averaged 203 through 37 games, bowled 7 events, had 2 top 5 individual finishes. Going for her 4-pin, runs it down with no problem at all. 10-pin now for Paige, runs that down. Paige Krauschar averaged 195 for 43 games through 7 events this year. The 4-9 bowler for Stephen F. Austin.
So Stephen F. Austin needs to go up and throw a double here in the 10th frame. It can get to 190. Arkansas State would then just have to get 7 pins to win.
Stephanie Schwartz with a strike. First ball of the 10th.
So Arkansas State here, 7 pins are better, and Arkansas State's going to get the win in game number one of this 7-game match. That's 7, Matt. That's 10.
There it goes.
So there you have it there. We'll take you back over 9 and 10. Uh-oh. An open in the 10th frame, 156 for Sam Houston State. Vanderbilt looking to take a 1-0 lead.
This is our first look at Vanderbilt. defending champions here. You're looking at Kristen Kwa sparing up her her leave. Kristen averaged 200.5 for 46 games across 8 events, had one top 5 individual finish this year. Vanderbilt University women's bowling won 3 tournaments last year in 2015. Their coach, John Williamson, is in his 11th season, and he was the 2007 NCAA Coach of the Year.
So Vanderbilt must make this. Robin Renslow does not convert, so Sam Houston State escapes luckily with a win there. Wow. Action underway, game number 2 in this 7-game match. Making some changes to the Vanderbilt roster.
They did make a change.
Got some changes, huh?
Yeah, they moved. Robin Renslow down into the anchor.
She moved to third then?
No, she moved to third. You're right. Kristen Kwa moved to the anchor spot, and Tori Ferris moved into the four hole.
Okay.
Giselle Poss and Jordan Newham, 1 and 2 respectively. So it looks like Tulane finished out 232. They started with the front 7.
Down on lanes 5 and 6 in the loser's bracket.
They defeated Valpo 166. Louisiana Tech lost to Monmouth 179-170. So Monmouth will take a 1-0 lead over Louisiana Tech.
So Tulane's up 1-0, Monmouth's up 1-0, Sam Houston State's up 1-0, and Arkansas State is up 1-0. Best of 7 matches, as we mentioned. And we apologize if there were some sound issues there, folks. We had to restart something and apologize if you didn't have sound. But we are back with you here. We'll take you around. Monmouth University currently right now is up 1-0 over Louisiana Tech. Tulane is up 1-0 over Valparaiso. Sam Houston State is up 1-0 over Vanderbilt. And right here, Arkansas State is up 1-0 over Stephen F. Austin. Thank you.
There's Brooke Wood running her 10-pin down. Here's a look at Stephanie Mims, our first look at Stephanie Mims for Arkansas State. Stephanie averaged 203 through 37 games across seven events, had two top five finishes individually. And she rips the cover off of the ball.
Well, the
10
second,
back, baby.
They're the second ranked team in the country in the NCAA rankings, and to bowl anchor on that team, you got to be pretty good.
Yeah.
And she gets a lot of revolutions on that bowling ball. Stephen F. Austin hanging in there right now.
Got a fan of Stephanie Mims in the chat. Her sister. Give a shout out to Nicole Mims.
Also give a shout out to Nick Carbonetto, also who is watching. Hello, Nick. I like what you shared on Facebook the other day. It was a bowling skit that was on Saturday Night Live recently. It's pretty cool. You should check it out.
Stephen F. Austin with a double. It's a pretty tight match over there. You're looking at Carly Larson for Stephen F. Austin. Working on the turkey. Crosses over, leaving the six pin. Nicole going for her 3-6 and covers it nicely. Oh, tough break there for Carly. Missing the six pin to the right. An open frame, they have 140 in the eighth. Double here for Arkansas State will be huge. Looking at J.D. Scott-Jones for Arkansas State. Coming in a little high, almost tripping the four pin out, but alas, it remains standing.
Possible 204 max score for Arkansas State. 200 even for Stephen F. Austin, but leaving the 1-2-10, that's going to be extinguished. We'll take you over to 9 and 10 where scoring is picked up. Sam Houston State with a big string of strikes right here. Looking to take a 2-0 lead over Vanderbilt. Vanderbilt with their back against the ropes here. Over here on 9 and 10. What a game here.
Yeah,
possible
278.
Yeah. And that's tough to do in this Baker competition. Remember, Baker, folks, the leadoff bowler bowls the first and the sixth. The second bowler bowls the second and seventh. And so on and so on, leading up to the anchor bowler bowling the fifth and the tenth frame. Four matches going on right now here at the Southland Bowling League.
Kristen Kwa leaving the three for Sam Houston. Tori Ferris with a great shot there for Vandy. Gives them a double on the board. They're just trying to get through this game, do the best they can, and move over to the other lane where they need to get things going. So barring tragedy, actually, it's official. Sam Houston State is up 2-0 over Vanderbilt. And that's a nice lead to have. They are in the winner's bracket. Tulane is still on fire on 5 and 6. They've moved over to 6, and they looks like they have a lead over Valpo right now in game number 2.
Okay, this one in the books, take you back over 13 and 14. Possible 179 for Stephen F. Austin, Arkansas State. Wow, well now it's close. Stephen F. Austin can go up and throw a double. Will force Arkansas State to spare and get 9. All starts here in the 10th frame. Out comes in, man. White.
Tough break, light break for Stephanie Schwartz there for Stephen F. Austin. Stephanie Mims now can just go up and spare, which she does.
Arkansas State's going to go up 2 zip.
Big shot down there for Tulane on lane 6. They've got a double going into the 10th. Valpo trying to save face this game.
It is loud in here, man.
Yep, it's so exciting. Sam Houston and Vandy are switching lanes.
And we'll take you there now.
For the win.
Arkansas State goes up 2-0 over Stephen F. Austin. Sam Houston State up 2-0 over Vanderbilt.
Tulane gets the first strike in the 10th for a turkey, and their hometown fans are loving it. Monmouth, 190 over Louisiana Tech, 172.
They're going to take a 2-0. Lead as well. A lot of 2-0 matches going on right now.
Yep.
All of them.
Yes! Let go!
Tulane get the W down there.
I can't see the score numbers, but they are riding, they're flying high. Turkey through one frame in the 10th.
They're going to be in the two teens, it looks like. Possibly 190 for Valparaiso. So, yes, every match is 2-0.
And they got another strike. Tulane with that victory. That is a contenders bracket match we are referring to. Loser is going to go home. Did you see Vanderbilt there with the 10 pin? Kara Grant. I apologize. Nicole, Mickey, your favorite name there, Mike. Mickalillian.
Yeah, Mickalillian is what I've been pronouncing that name as, Nicole. The one thing that is important to know about Nicole is she throws a really fantastic bowling ball down the lane. She's very fundamentally sound. She's got great fundamentals. Stays down and through the shot. Sam Houston State looking to go up 3-0 on the defending champs.
Robin Renslow, 4-7.
She was just, I don't really like to use this word, but she was demoted. She was taken out of the 5-hole. Isn't quite lined up, but the thing about Vanderbilt is they have so many great female bowlers on their team that they've got several anchor bowlers that bowl in regular spots on their lineup. They're that talented.
Yeah. Yeah, Vanderbilt is a very good program. In 2007, they won the NCAA tournament, which is the event after this one, actually.
Yeah.
Great program, Vanderbilt University.
Spare converted. Game number three, best of seven match. Mike Flanagan here with you, along with Matt Turek here on InsideBowling.com. We're happy you're watching college bowling today. We will be here with you all afternoon, and then tomorrow morning we'll come back and present the semifinals and the final matches here at the Southland Bowling League. Second year for the Southland Bowling League, and I'll tell you what, Matt, we walked through the door. We've been working with Melissa Siebold and Stephanie McDonald, and they have done a great job putting this event on. The place looks spectacular. Just a first-class event here that we're part of. Also want to thank Chris McCoskey for the opportunity to stream this event as well. Chris, I know you're watching today. Thanks for all the tweets and whatnot. Let people know that you're watching college bowling. Go out and tweet. Get on Instagram. Take some screenshots. Go on the old book, the old Facebook, and let people know you're watching college bowling today. We sure would appreciate a share of the link. And we appreciate everybody watching today.
Tulane is off to another hot start. Strike, 10 pin.
Got to give a shout out to Matt Hicks, Nikesha Cardona, who are watching online right now, TJ Reed, Paul Wehner. David De La Torre asks, who is the favorite? And that is Arkansas State. They would be your favorites. They're the number one seed. And since you asked, you shall receive. We'll take you right over there right now where you can see Arkansas State here on the left side of your screen. They're up 2-0 in this match against Stephen F. Austin.
And Stephanie Mims with a nice strike there in the fifth. They're clean. Strike, spare, strike. Tulane, when you hear the big entire bowling center cheer, that's Tulane. They're striking again. Here's Paige Beeney for Stephen F. Austin. She gets a strike. Arkansas State now going for the 6-10. Haley Richard covers it up. No problem at all.
Yeah, I'll tell you what. It is important in all these 2-0 matches right now, Matt, that we see some teams get on the board. Because going down 3-0.
Yeah, that's rough.
It's almost impossible to come back from 3-0. We've seen it before in college competition, but very, very difficult.
Kiara Grant with a strike there, giving Stephen F. Austin a double. Nicole leaving that four pin for Arkansas State.
Stephen F. Austin right here has an opportunity to go up and make it a triple.
Dakota Hazelwood for Stephen F. Austin.
Comes in high, the southpaw, leaves the 2-4. So it looks like with three frames to go for Arkansas State, possible 226 with two frames to go if they convert the spare here. 223 possible max score. So about a three-pin match over there on 13 and 14.
Oh, we apologize there. Looks like they must have made a change during the game for Arkansas State. Jordan Richard is now the anchor. Even have Austin with a strike there.
I just went and confirmed with Justin Kostick, the coach from Arkansas State, and we do now have our lineup correct. Stephen F. Austin with a strike here can close out game number three. Ouch, oh. Comes in high, okay. So possible 2-0-2 left for Arkansas State. Stephen F. Austin with two pins here will bowl 195.
So here's Jordan Richard now for Arkansas State.
Yeah, she's going to have to double an attempt to go up three games to none.
Jordan Richard averaged 205 for 46 games across seven events, had two top five finishes this year.
That was a great shot, but it's going to be not enough.
Gonna shoot back down to the Vanderbilt Sam Houston match. Sam Houston, 168. Vandy needs a spare to win by one pin here. And you're watching Kristen Kwa up in the 10th frame. Kristen, 200 average this year. All they need is a spare to win. Carries the four pin, and that's a win for Vanderbilt.
Wow.
And they wanted it, man.
College bowling is exciting.
Monmouth, 215 over Louisiana Tech, 176.
They go up three games to none.
It looks like Valpo might be beating Tulane. Tulane has got lots of spares up. I cannot see the numbers. Looks like.
Yeah. Tulane, or I'm. Stephen F. Austin won. Got the lead, yeah.
So is that 2-1?
2-1, yeah.
Tulane with a strike up on lane five. Here's Haley Richard for Arkansas State, starting off game number four in the second round.
Oh, Haley Richard and Jordan Richard.
Yeah.
Are they sisters?
I don't know.
Maybe they can help us out in the chat.
Maybe. Haley Richard averaged 201 for 40 games across seven events, had two top five finishes.
We do have some folks here in the chat helping us out.
It is a best of seven match. First team to win four games will advance. It is double elimination. Each team must lose twice to be eliminated from the tournament. That includes the championship match.
So Stephen F. Austin now getting lined up. Arkansas State, your number one seed. Stephen F. Austin coming in as the four seed. Sam Houston State and Vanderbilt, your three and two seeds. So all of the favorites won in our first round of brackets that we did this morning. Brought to you here on InsideBowling.com.
Looks like Jordan and Haley Richard are twins, according to the chat.
Thank you very much, Ms. Cardona, for that information. Arkansas State now getting lined up as well. Scores are going to start going up as the ladies start to understand this lane condition a little bit better. And as oil begins to be taken off of the lane, friction means scores. And as they attack this oil pattern and the bowling ball picks up oil off the lane, it removes oil, soaks into the bowling balls, and you start to see the ball hook more off the spot. A lot of 2-4-10s. And things like that now turn into two pins. As I say that, up on lane 14, we see a two pin on a shot where they miss just a little bit wide. What do you got for us, Matt?
I've got an update on the Tulane-Valpo match. Tulane 201, Valpo 170. So Tulane has got a 3-0 lead on Valpo. Valpo bowled really good in the first round, got knocked out to the elimination bracket, and Tulane has a chance to put them away for good.
Yeah, two teams are going to be eliminated this round, and right now it looks like both teams being down 3-0. Louisiana Tech trailing Monmouth 3-0, and Valpo right now, as you just mentioned, down 3-0 to Tulane.
So here's Jordan Richard for Arkansas State coming in a little light, tripping out pins, leaving just a five. It's not too terrible.
Take it back down over to lanes 9 and 10 right here in front of our booth. Vanderbilt versus Sam Houston State. Sam Houston State up on the right lane. They have the lead 2-1. Vanderbilt rallying last game to win. Trying to get things even, yeah. Steven here. Sam Houston State did something that neither team could do in the first match on lanes 9 and 10, which was to win a game on lane 9.
That's a very true statement. Every match or every game was won on 10 last round.
She really torques through that ball.
Ooh.
Look at that ball reaction.
That was Heather Pantenzer from Arkansas. Oh, I'm sorry, I was looking at the wrong screen.
Vanderbilt.
I
want to welcome in all of our viewers. Thanks for watching today. College bowling at its finest. Southern Bowling League. Southland Bowling League Championship. AMF All-Star Lanes here in Kenner, Louisiana. Mike Flanagan and Matt Turek here with you.
Bringing you the action.
We sure are. Next round, things are going to slow down a little bit as we'll just have two matches. One we'll have on our feature pair. One we'll bring you some bonus coverage for. And then the same thing will happen on our next round. So 2:30 today and at 4:15 today is when we'll bring you those games. So we will have a little break in the action, which I believe will afford us the opportunity to have lunch.
I like that sound. Tulane down there, spare strike to start their match. They are trying to put Valpo away for good. They are the hometown favorites. There's quite a crowd behind them watching.
I'm going to take you directly over here because we got some strikes happening.
Stephen F. Austin.
Can still bowl 247. That's a huge game. I believe the high game of the tournament if they could finish it off.
It may be. It may be.
Arkansas State bowling a great game as well. Best they can do, though, 228. Stephen F. Austin looking to tie this thing up and take it to 2-2, Matt.
Stephanie Schwartz for Stephen F. Austin will be up here in the 10th trying to close out that high game. She averaged 210 this year for 42 games across 7 events, had 1 top 1 finish and 3 top 5 finishes this year. She is no slouch at bowling. And here's a look at her in the 10th. Ring 10. Arkansas State with a tough break, a 7-10 split in the 9th frame for Arkansas State. That would be Brooke Wood. Brooke averaged 200 this year, bowled 7 events. She's got 44 games under her belt. She gets good wood and gets the count. Tulane is striking at will down there. Stephen F. Austin with the spare.
So with that
strike here,
match
we're getting 226.
Over.
Yeah, that match is over. Stephen F. Austin tied it. Well, the game is over.
The match is not.
It's just beginning.
Best of 7, folks. Great time to remind you of that. It's the best out of 7.
And Stephen F. Austin and Arkansas State are tied 2-2.
These are some interesting color combinations on the telescores here on these lanes 9 and 10. Possible 202 left for Vanderbilt. And with that shot right there, Sam Houston State now has a triple up on the board. Can still bowl 223. Sam Houston State looking good right now.
Vanderbilt answers with a strike. I'm sorry, a spare in the 9th. Kristen Kwa now up for Vanderbilt. But stepping up onto the approach first is Heather Pentenzer with 3 in a row for her team in the 10th frame. Coming off the spot, rolling the 7 out. I love it.
I heard him saying that chant earlier, and I actually said that we were in Texas because I heard them say that, but we're actually in Kenner, Louisiana.
So Heather now up. Looking to give Sam Houston 5 in a row to at the end of this game. That'll give Sam Houston a 3-1 lead over Vanderbilt. Vanderbilt can spare a strike for 191. This match is all over. Sorry, this game is all over. Sam Houston State will go up 3-1. Louisiana Tech, though, let's talk about Louisiana Tech for a second. They're down on the high end. They defeated this game, Monmouth, 189 to 159. So they're hanging on by a thread.
Louisiana Tech trails 3-1. Tulane is still going on. Looks like Tulane, though, is rolling right now.
It does look that way.
Looks like Tulane's going to shut out Valpo, and Valpo's going to go home. They have a possible 244 max score through eight, and Valpo quite a bit behind there in the sixth frame. Can only bowl 221. So looks like Tulane is going to advance. Sam Houston State up now 3-1 over Vanderbilt. An opportunity to close out the defending champions coming up here in the next game. Action underway, game number five. Stephen F. Austin, Arkansas State, all squared up to a piece.
Arkansas State, big shot for them right there. Big spare. Here's J.D. Scott-Jones for Arkansas State, your number one seed, as she rolls the bucket out like it was nothing.
And like I was talking about, that's when the lanes start to dry up a little bit. You remove oil from the outside part of the lane, and that shot earlier is a two-pin or worse.
Yep.
And now it's coming in. It's starting
to
hit line. Yeah. So great shot. Lanes are coming to him. Great match happening right here in front of us. 13-14. Stephen F. Austin, Arkansas State, 2-2. Game number five. That ball comes off the spot and goes sideways. And
yeah, Brooke Wood.
Looking good out there. And now the southpaw answers with a strike.
Dakota Hazelwood. Dakota averaged 190. Bowled more events than anybody on her team with eight. And has got 33 games under her belt this year. Jordan Richard with the 2-8 leave on lane 13.
We've now seen two shots by these two teams come in light, leaving the 2-4 and the 2-8.
Jordan covers it up nicely.
Jordan's a sophomore.
Arkansas State, Haley Richard. Unless there was a substitution with a strike. They got a nice game going. Vanderbilt.
Janine is now the anchor for Sam Houston.
Janine.
Sam Houston.
Sam Houston. Janine.
And speaking of Sam Houston, we'll take you over there now. Go! Vanderbilt with a strike. Yeah. And she's been striking like crazy.
That's Kristen Kwa. Kristen averaged 200.
So far this college season, she's averaging 200?
Yep. She's got 46 games, bowled 8 events.
And just to let people at home that are watching know, the conditions that college bowling puts out for the athletes are tough bowling lane conditions. Very, very difficult to score. So a 200 average is exceptional.
Fairly, it's very good. Very good. The highest average I've seen out of all of these teams is 210. And that is by a member of Arkansas State. I just take that back right now. Jordan Kaza, 225 average, but she's only got 11 games. She bowled pretty well when she did bowl two events.
Small sample size, but. Uh-oh. Oh, I thought she was going to pick that up. Almost gave that a run right there. I'll tell you, it's fun watching them throw hard and straight at spares. Anything can happen. You see pins bounce around. So Sam Houston State really putting it to Vanderbilt right here. Trying to put Vanderbilt in the loser's bracket. Cool. Sam Houston State is rolling along.
Go check an update.
Another match here.
Quick update. Tulane, 191. Valpo, 124.
So Tulane advances.
Valpo goes home.
So Arkansas State in control here. They're going to go up 3-2.
We got quite the match brewing here on our on 9-10. Sam Houston. And Vanderbilt. Vanderbilt trying to stay alive, as you alluded to earlier. Ooh, lucky break for Vanderbilt off camera. .237 for Arkansas State. And they defeated Stephen F. Austin.
Yeah, and they take a 3-2 lead now. Okay, Matt, so here
this
we
is,
go.
Yeah, this is it.
Yeah, it sure is.
For the number one seed, correction, number two seed, the Vanderbilt, defending champions.
Still alive, though. They'll move down to the loser's bracket. Sam Houston State's put on an impressive performance here on lanes 9 and 10.
Yes!
Good shot right there for Vanderbilt. Still bowl at 209.
Tori Ferris.
So, it's not over yet, Matt. I mean,
no.
This spare is critical. I expect she's going to pick this up, though.
Anna Groach.
No, she does not.
Wow.
She does not get the sleeper, does not get the 8-pin. So, drama unfolding here right in front of us.
Yeah, max score of 221.
209 max score for Vanderbilt.
Vanderbilt needs them all.
So if Kristen Kwan can go up and double in a 10th frame, that will force Sam Houston State to double as well.
Yeah!
What a great looking shot right there from that young lady. She has been nothing but strikes on this pair. She has been striking at will. Really impressed with her game.
Oh, big strike there.
And Sam Houston State answers with a strike.
Have an update from Louisiana Tech and Monmouth. Louisiana Tech is coming back, 216 to 180. They are just holding on by thread. Loser of that match is going to go home. As we have a very important shot here for Kristen Kwa.
And if you're interested in seeing how the bracket looks, go to insidebowling.com, click on the banner at the top, and down below our feed, you'll see the bracket. You can look at the bracket right there. I do have a question in the chat about that. That's where you can find that. So here we go. Kristen Kwa. To keep them alive in the winner's bracket and force Sam Houston State to get a strike.
Yes!
She's got it.
Great shot.
Let go! Let go!
Great shot for Kristen.
And this is what it's all about. It's these sorts of moments that she will remember for the rest of her life when she looks back at college bowling, those opportunities to go up and strike in the 10th frame, keep her team in a match.
Is she going to roll the 10? No.
No, she is not.
Janine did not roll the 10. So they have a 211 max score.
So they did just shut them out with that shot right there. It is a shutout, and Vanderbilt does.
Stay alive.
Vanderbilt does not stay alive. Sam Houston State advances, Matt. I think you were looking at the score backwards.
I think I was. You're right.
So, but hey, what an effort here from Kristen Kwa. As soon as that first strike was in the 10th for Sam Houston.
Yeah, 209 to 211. If they fill everything.
Yep. So
Sam Houston advances.
So there you have it. Vanderbilt gets defeated by Sam Houston State 4-1. You see the ladies congratulate one another. Awesome bowling. Now we'll take you over to our remaining match that we have going on here over on lanes 13 and 14. Stephen F. Austin and Arkansas State. Arkansas State up 3-2.
And Stephen F. Austin quite a bit ahead, two frames ahead of Arkansas State in this game.
Happy you're with us here, watching college bowling, NCAA action here. Southland Bowling League Championship. Micah Matt here with you from insidebowling.com. Appreciate the opportunity to be bringing you this college bowling. We love bringing you bowling and the exciting bowling and camaraderie that these ladies show. We're treated to be here.
We are. This is a something special. It's a great shot there for Arkansas State. But Stephen F. Austin has got the lead in this match, or in this game. Stephen F. Austin putting up a turkey.
Yeah. Turkey time. We got a microphone right down there on the lanes too, folks, that we that the bowlers are right up next to. So you get to hear all the sounds right from the lanes. Stephen F. Austin looking to take this to a game number 7. Seventh frame now.
Be a game 6 here if Stephen F. Austin wins. They're tied 2-2.
No, they're not. They're up 3-2. Arkansas State is up 3-2.
I stand corrected. Thank you. Louisiana Tech down there. Quick update. Started out this game with the first four strikes against Monmouth. Monmouth had a 3-0 lead on them in that match, and Louisiana Tech have won the last two games in a row. And that is a loser's bracket match. The loser will go home. Very exciting stuff.
Louisiana Tech just kind of hanging in there.
The number 8 seed at the tournament.
So possible 249 left for Arkansas State. 237 for Arkansas State. 249 for Stephen F. Austin.
Oh, that's a tough break.
Yeah, it was just a bad shot. It was left off her hand, went through the face, and pays the ultimate penalty now.
Carly Larson.
Big strike for her. Wow. Left lane on this 13-14 has been good. Right lane's been a little bit tougher. They keep going back and forth on these lanes 13 and 14.
Page with 10 back for Stephen F. Austin. Here's J.D. Scott-Jones for Arkansas State coming in, and another split. Back-to-back splits for Arkansas State, and that could just about do it this game. Stephen F. Austin pushes to game 7.
We wouldn't have it any other way.
Not at all. They're going to get a ball change or a player change here for Stephen F. Austin.
Yeah, we probably need to keep up with that. Tell you what, folks, college bowling is one of the toughest bowling events to broadcast from the chair that we sit in with so many people here, so many substitutions, so many matches going on, really quick pace of play, too. These ladies take no time. They bowl very, very quickly, which I would, too, in a Baker format because you've been sitting and sitting and sitting and waiting for four other people to bowl. And a lot of moving parts here and just doing the best we can to bring you all the information as we can. I'll tell you what, this particular match is really going to be telling because the number one seed has an opportunity to go to the loser's bracket. In a one-game match, really. That's what it's going to boil down to, is a one-game match.
It's going to be exciting. Sam Houston State, the number three, number three seed.
And they've already advanced.
They did. Stephen F. Austin, the number four seed, we're watching here. As you said, trying to take the number one seed down to the loser's bracket.
And Arkansas State, you know, was the favorite last year as well and bowled for the title and lost to Vanderbilt. And I talked to Justin Kostick, their coach, and they want this tournament. They want the Southland Bowling League Championship. And the fact that they didn't win last year is something that they thought about the whole way here this year. Do you have a sound effect or something for me, Matt? Can you give me a sound effect? Boom, there you go. The graphic just updated thanks to Matt's sound effect. Stephen F. Austin 3, Arkansas State now 3 as we wrap up game number 6. Matt, this has been fun. This has been great. And we're just getting started, really. Don't forget, folks. Absolutely. We've got this game 7 coming up. See who's going to advance. And don't forget, coming up today at 2:30 p.m., We'll have matches 9 and 10, which is the two games in the losers bracket. It'll be
Tulane and the loser of the match we're watching here.
You're correct. Yeah, absolutely. So, and then we'll also have either Louisiana Tech or Monmouth.
Which is over, and we're about to get an update right now, I believe, of who won. I cannot.
Looks like Monmouth won.
Yeah.
But they are switching lanes. I don't know. Are they going to another game? Yes, they are. They are going to another game.
Louisiana Tech, 236. Monmouth, 207.
Wow. Wow.
That's incredible.
So they've come back. Louisiana Tech.
They were up 3-0.
They are staying alive. Just like the Bee Gees said, they are staying
alive. I'm not familiar with that song, Mike. Can you maybe enlighten me on how that goes?
Yeah.
We're in between action.
I'll bring it up on YouTube in between the next round.
All right.
Let you listen to that. So here we go. Stephen F. Austin, Arkansas State, 3-3. Monmouth and Louisiana Tech, 3-3. We will get you some bonus coverage from the Louisiana Tech match down there with our wireless camera. I will do that for you in just a little bit.
So here, Haley Richards starting it off for Arkansas State. Great shot for Arkansas State. Yeah, there's some fans in the chat. Paige Beanie for Stephen F. Austin now up, trying to match the strike from Arkansas State. Oh, great shot, just a little flat, leaving the 10 pin. Very easy spare.
And to Mike M., who's watching right now, we will get that updated for you in between the next break. But if you're filling out your bracket at home, Arkansas State advanced over Louisiana Tech. Stephen F. Austin advanced over Monmouth. Sam Houston State advanced over Tulane. Vanderbilt advanced over Valpo. And then what happened was Arkansas State and Stephen F. Austin right now taking on each other in this last game of the seven-game match. Sam Houston State defeated Vanderbilt. So in your loser's bracket, you will have Vanderbilt versus the winner of Louisiana Tech Monmouth. And you will have Tulane taking on whoever does not advance in this match. So that will get you up to speed on your bracket. And Arkansas State opens with the double. And now an open frame for Stephen F. Austin.
Here's J.D. Scott Jones for Arkansas. Great shot, trip of the four, pin to the side, getting three in a row. This should be Dakota Hazelwood unless they made a substitution on Stephen F. Austin, which I believe they did. I think that's Kiara Grant.
We do have an observation here in our chat that the left lane has appeared to be easier and that Arkansas State should win, according to Chris Zona. Thanks for the observation, Chris. We will see.
Oh, trying to get the lucky break.
Almost.
Yeah.
Justin Kostick, the coach from Arkansas State, just said a few words over to the booth. He said, you know, he said a lot of times in these events and women's bowling, you know, a lot of it in that when it comes down to one game, you know, just hitting the head pin, the good breaks and the bad breaks sometimes can determine a match. He was sweating that last one right there. So Arkansas State rolling. Triple nine spare, anchor bowler up now. For an opportunity to still have a max score of 279. And that'd be pretty cool to watch.
Jordan Richard Boom goes the Dynamite.
Yeah, she's pretty good.
Beautiful shot.
No question. So now Stephen F. Austin's going to have to put together some strikes. They're going to have to put together three, four, maybe five in a row now. Starts with one, but comes in light for the 10 pin, a little half pocket hit there. Good shot, though. Arkansas State, they can keep rolling here. They can advance.
Haley Richard on 13. Boom, another strike. They are just rocking and rolling. Anchor bowler for Stephen F. Austin. Believe it is Stephanie Schwartz. Silently puts the ball in the lane, comes in high, trips out the six pin, breaking up the split.
Yeah, and I thought that was a better shot than to leave a split, so that's fortunate she got the six out.
She rolled
that ball pretty good. That was a pretty good shot on that right lane.
Nicole Michalillian now up on lane 13. Great shot from Arkansas State. They are just going, boy. Coach is loving it. And it's really quiet down there from the Lady Texters.
I just heard you say the Lady Texters, and I didn't realize
like texting?
With today's technology, I bet they didn't know when they became the Lady Texters that it would actually have to do and cross over with being the Lady Texters.
It is spelled differently, but it sounds the same.
It sounds the same. That's pretty cool. I don't see any of them on their cell phones right now, though,
no.
Matt. They're concentrating on
bowling.
They
are. J.D. Scott Jones left the 7-pin to end Arkansas State's enormous run and missed it to the right, but they have a commanding lead in this match. And here we are with a little bit of bonus coverage. We as Louisiana Tech and Monmouth battling it out.
Yeah, and just to let you know, Matt, this game's just about over, really. I'll bring you up to the scoreboard here, but as you can see, Monmouth still possible 239, possible 199 for Louisiana Tech. So still mathematically possible, but right now if we see a good shot out of Monmouth, which we just did, Monmouth is going to move on to advance.
Thanks, Mike. Pretty good shot from Louisiana Tech there, a little bit high. And I assume then that match is all but over.
Just about, yeah, 10th frame here now. Anchor bowler working on a double going in the 10th frame. If she gets a strike here, you'll see him erupt. Yep, that's right.
Whoop. And we'll bring you back down here. As that match is pretty much over to 13 and 14. As this match is almost pretty much over, Arkansas State has got, what does that say there, 2:15 left with a spare strike. For Arkansas State,
Arkansas State can still bowl 215. And the best Stephen F. Austin can do is 193. So it's already closed out. Arkansas State is going to get the win.
They will battle Sam Houston State. Monmouth will take on Vanderbilt. And Tulane cruised to a match with Stephen F. Austin.
So just finishing up here, just a couple of last shots. Stephen F. Austin. As we update our graphic, Arkansas State does get the win, 4-2-3.
Stephen F. Austin will move on to battle Tulane, who is the hometown favorite. Stephen F. Austin now just finishing up this game, going after this three pin. That'll give them 182. They cover it up. So that concludes it as they all huddle up and congratulate each other. And you're going to want to join us back here for the third round at about 2:30.